another one. Hello everyone, the Sheep Killer here, and welcome back to Pokemon Leaf Green. And last time we were about halfway through the Sevii Island side quest, and well, I decided to do a bit of extra exploration off camera, but now we are back. And now it's time to explore more of the main quest of the Sevii Island subquest at the end of the game. Post game, I mean. And now we're gonna explore more, and that music. Oh, it's just gonna cut my sound effect. That music! It's Johto music right there, guys. Oh, Team Rocket Grunt. Okay, so we got some grunts to battle. And I didn't super speed that entire battle, which is kinda rare for me. I normally always super speed battles unless they're like main story battles, but I guess that battle I didn't super speed. But that was actually a Team Rocket Grunt there, which means that Team Rocket is back. Well, we did battle some Team Rocket Grunts last episode, of course. We got this one to battle as well. That one was an optional battle, but I'm gonna battle it anyway. And this time I'm actually gonna super speed it, because you know me, I always super speed stuff. And we are way over leveled, though. But yeah, I always like to battle all the trainers, just to get as much experience as possible. And since we are doing the Elite Four rematches for the final episode, you know, I want to get as high leveled as possible, because those set of battles are pretty tough. I believe they're in like the level 60s, and the rival is the 70s. I'm pretty sure that's how it goes. And we've got another boom. Oh, we got a crit that time, so we just missed a good shot. Okay, good job, Sanic. Good work there. And this is the introduction to female grunts into Leaf Green. It's the first female grunt we've seen this entire playthrough, believe it or not. Let's go surf over here and see what's over here. I'm going to backtrack a little bit. And, well, sidetrack, I mean. Here we got yet another PP up, which is always very good for King. He's got his Giga Drain. And I believe it's up to its max now. I'm not sure, let me see. Let's go through all my Pokemon's. Actually, let me review my whole team. Sanic actually got some decent speed. I thought Sanic would be pretty slow. But he's got pretty good attack and HP and very good defense. That's like some phenomenal defense there. And Roshan got that very good attack stat, and okay, speed, I guess, and the special attack's decent. And then, Juvia has way higher attack than special attack for some reason, even though I've had Juvia wanting to be a special attacker, has all special attacks. And King's got some very balanced stats there. And yeah, Giga Drain is at 8 PP now, which I believe is the max for it, the max for that Giga Drain could go. And wow, King and Thor have the exact same physical attack stat. And Thor's got some good moves there as well. And Chico or Shining Pidgeot, still our weakest member, but has a pretty solid moveset. So yeah, that's just our team now. I always like to review my team every so often, because, you know, I'm forgetful, I just forget things. And here we got this next team, Rocket Grunt here. Oh, he's got Memento. Okay, after constantly lowering my Axie, this decided to use Memento. You know, I could easily switch, right? You never use Memento unless your opponent's on their last Pokemon, because they get to switch out and be a total troll. Sanic trying to learn Sandstorm here. I believe he has the ability Sand Veil, so it would actually be pretty nice if I wanted to learn it. I believe he actually got a TM for Sandstorm in the past, and I just sold it because I didn't have any use for it. But anyway, now they got to go on to their last Pokemon here, Weezing. Yeah, this is the last Pokemon. Thought I was going to have to crit myself there, but I was right, they had two Pokemon. Now we're going to use Double Edge, which is a very powerful move with Roshan's over 200 physical attack stat. Yeah, there's no way that could have not one-shot. I mean, Weezing's defense isn't the best, and we are way over-leveled as well. So I guess you could be in the high 40s and not struggle in the post-game, like the high level 40s. If you didn't train up to the 50s for the end of the game, you could still do pretty good in this part of the post-game. But, of course, if you wanted to do the 4 rematches, you couldn't, because, well, they would be in, like, their high 60s. And we enter the first password, but another password is needed. We need another one. And let's go off to the right here. Actually, this is some off-roading here. So, you guys can go explore that for yourselves if you're playing through Leaf Green. See, I don't want to go through everything on Leaf Green, because it's not a walkthrough, so I'm not required to go through everything. And also, well, I just find the other islands because I've been to them already. So basically what my main goal is for this series is not to explore the entire game on camera. That's not what my overall goal is anymore, and I can't fly. What I want is to go through the main parts of the game, and if you guys are playing along, you can go explore the other parts on your own, and if you, for some reason, never played Kanto games, then you can just go off and explore it on your own and discover it yourselves. That's what I like doing with games myself, is discovering it all on my own. That's why I'm not going to look at any Sun and Moon information that's revealed or leaked or anything. Because, you know, I want to figure it out all on my own. I don't want it to be leaked to me before the game comes out. I want to discover it all on my own. And that's what I want you guys to do if you haven't played through Kanto yet, is discovering the stuff that I skip on your own. And I believe my rival did come in here. Like, he was in this Pokemon Center. But, you know, I accidentally paid him a visit off camera, so... Yeah, he just said he was gonna go back to Kanto because he was bored. Yeah, that was just in a nutshell. I am still going through all the story stuff, and I already got that item over there. There's a hidden item over there. Yeah, I am still gonna go through all the story stuff, but all the extra stuff that you, I'm just gonna let you guys explore it on your own. Because, you know, you can easily replay through these games. You just have to download an emulator on your computer or your phone, and it's that easy. You don't even have to go back and buy the original. Or if you have the original on your Game Boy Advance, you can just do that as well. That's just as simple. You won't have super speed or access to cheat codes, which I don't use cheat codes anyway. But, you know, it's still the same old good game. Regardless, you're playing this game that is really fun. And I haven't just been rambling as I'm exploring, and that's actually Dragon Scale there. Of course, on emulators, you can't trade, so you couldn't get access to trade evolutions. And if you did have multiple real copies of the game, then you could trade still. And you can even bring them up to all the way up to Gen 6 for transferring. And I'm pretty sure, well, I can absolutely guarantee pretty much that you will be able to transfer your Gen 6 Pokemon over to Sun and Moon. I mean, you could transfer Gen 1 for Pete's sake. I'm saying that a lot now. I used to never say that, but once these games came along, it just popped in my head. Boom! I managed to one-shot Kazuroshan's amazing physical attack. Yeah, I've just been rambling on this entire episode pretty much, just about, like, you guys can explore this stuff on your own, which is true. If you guys haven't played through these games, then you can explore this stuff and discover it on your own. After all, I don't want to be going through the entire game, because then you guys would have no reason to play it, because I've been through it all. So yeah, I don't think that walkthroughs are necessarily good. And yes, I do watch Psycho's walkthroughs, but you know, I don't think that walkthroughs are necessarily a good thing, because you know, if you can watch someone do every single thing in a game, then you have no reason to play it, because you've already seen everything that could possibly be done in the game. So when I do a playthrough, I don't want to be here doing everything. And you guys will have no reason to play it yourselves, because you will know everything. But if I don't play through everything, then you guys could be like, this game looks fine, but there's some stuff he skips. I could just get the game, and in whatever way I do get the game, and just play it on my own. So yeah, I'm just giving you guys a reason to play through these games. Play through the whole games by yourselves. Because I do play through the entire game, but I don't play through it all on camera. Because if I play through the whole thing, I'm just repeating myself down here, but if I play through the whole thing, you guys have no reason to play it. And you guys can play through this game and experience the fun on your own if you guys don't watch me do everything. So I do go through the story, but I don't go through the extra stuff. And if I skip that stuff, you guys have a reason to play it. And like I said before, that's the reason why I don't want to know anything about Sun and Moon prior to it, except for the starters, of course. Because I want a reason to play through the whole thing, discover everything, and thoroughly enjoy it. because I just wanted to discover the new things in Sun and Moon. I didn't in Gen 6, I figured out everything, and now, with Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire revealing all the Mega Evolutions, I realized that it's boring if you know stuff before the game comes out. Why not just play through the game and discover it on your first playthrough? It'll be a lot more fun of an experience that way. So, discovering stuff on your own when you play a game, not knowing hardly anything prior to playing the game, it's more fun because you get to discover stuff. It's more fun to discover stuff on your first playthrough of a game. If you know stuff before it, it's gonna be boring because you know this stuff. You're like, oh yeah, this is how I do this and all that. And like, oh yeah, this thing existed. No, you weren't. I want to discover it myself. Some people actually do prefer knowing it before it comes out, so that they don't have to struggle or anything, but that's just too convenient and just too boring. I want to be adventurous and struggle through the game as if it's like a brand new thing that I haven't done before. That's what video games are pretty much about, is like discovering stuff. Everything being revealed before it comes out makes it really boring. Of course, for direct remakes like Twilight Princess HD or Wind Waker HD, you do want to know the new stuff because, you know, it could really catch you off guard in a bad way. You know, like the Amiibo features in Twilight Princess HD. If you didn't know that, then you wouldn't know that there will be Amiibos to go with the game, and like, you could use Amiibos in the game. So when it comes to, like, direct remakes that have, like, a few secret features, you want to know those secret features, but when it comes to a brand new game, or like a Pokemon remake, you don't really want to know much. You could discover it all on your own. And you will know the story and all that, but if it's like Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, or Heart Gold, Soul Silver, you want to discover all the new stuff that's added. You don't want to just play through it boringly, and playing through a game blindly is more fun. Playing through it blindly is like the best way to play through it, pretty much. That makes it as fun as possible, pretty much. And I've been rambling this entire episode just about a new experience in a game, and I've probably repeated myself a few times. Yeah, this episode I've just been rambling. And I'm gonna stop rambling now. I'm not actually gonna pay attention to the game now. Well, some of you guys probably like just me rambling about one-off topics in my videos instead of focusing on the game. You know, if I'm just here in my own little world while playing a game, something crazy happens, it could catch me off guard, and that'd make it for a better video, because I'd be more excited. That's kind of what happened with my first shiny encounter, the Rattata. I was just talking about how weak Rattatas are, then I ran into a shiny Rattata, I'm like, whoa, that's crazy! So yeah, when stuff catches you off guard like that, it makes it a lot more fun and exciting. I really like being excited, because, you know, life's kind of boring sometimes, so getting excited in the game just makes it so much better. And if you're not excited when you find something in the game, it just makes playing games about as bland as living normal life. So you want playing games to be like a way to have more fun, and a way to experience something new. You don't want to know stuff before it comes out, that makes it boring. You might as well not play it if you know everything. That's why my playthrough of Alpha Sapphire was very boring and shallow. Playing through Gen 6, it wasn't boring just because the games were short and easy. It was also boring because I knew stuff, and if I didn't know that stuff, the games were short and easy. But they could have still been. They could have still been fun if I didn't know the things, but since I knew the things, it made them even boring than they already were from being so short and easy. So yeah, and games like Pokemon are pretty short. So you want to not know the stuff to make it as fun as possible, because it's a short game, a short experience. So you don't want to know the stuff, because, well, if you do, the game's already short, so it's going to be pretty boring. It could still be fun, because, you know, Pokemon's Pokemon, but it could be even more fun if you didn't know the stuff. I mean, some people just don't get that, and they want to know all this stuff, like, just know, learn stuff, learn, know stuff. Before the game comes out, because they want to get excited about getting the game. But I don't want to be too overhyped about a Pokemon game anymore, because when you know all this crazy stuff before the game comes out, you're way too hyped for the game, and then when the game comes out, it's short and easy, and ends up being underwhelming. Because you knew all this stuff, so it wasn't a new experience. Because you knew all of it before the game came out. So yeah, Pokemon games are short, so if you know all this stuff before it comes out, then it's not gonna be fun at all, pretty much. I mean, it'll still be slightly entertaining because it's Pokemon, but it's not really gonna be fun, you know? Because, well, you knew all of it before it came out. And actually right here, the door doesn't budge at all, check it more thoroughly. There's just a bunch of Braille. Yeah, I am done rambling now. Hopefully I am, at least. And yeah, you actually have to use cut to open that door. That's the dotted hole. Which, you do have to go through these holes in a certain pattern. Yeah, I don't really remember the order. To finish off what I was saying, if you know stuff before a game comes out, if it's a short game, it's not gonna be entertaining. It's fine if it's a long, story-based game, but if it's a short game, it's not gonna be a good experience. Because you're gonna know everything, and it's just not gonna be that a good time as much of a good time as it could be. Because you want to discover this stuff on the short game, on a game that's short and easy. You want to discover stuff throughout your first playthrough, so that it could be as entertaining as possible. And if you know everything, it's only gonna be slightly entertaining because it's Pokemon. But it could be very entertaining if you discover the new stuff on your own. Okay, and that about wraps it up. That about wraps up my rambling. Yeah, just discovering stuff on your own in the game makes it a lot more entertaining. And, oh, I'm actually making some progress here. Yeah, I'm done rambling now, I promise. Ooh, we're actually making some decent progress. Is it gonna go like this? Oh yeah, that was actually the right order. I believe it was up, left, right, and down. And we're gonna find the sapphire, but then this son of a gun here. Foo-foo-foo-foo-foo-foo-foo. He really wants his foo-foo. I guessed right. I was right in tailing you. Red, why couldn't you just take it before he went and stole it from you? He's gonna tell us the password. The password I know is yes, nah, Chansey. Yeah, now we're gonna go and get that last password, and it's just a bunch of rail, but I don't even know what it means. Oh, I think we just clicked it again. Yeah, don't click on it. Look at this. Oh, we can actually escape. Okay. Go back to Realm Valley, I guess. So yeah, now we have to go back to Five Islands, so we can just fly back to the Pokemon Center. Make it an easier trip. Yeah, that was so much rambling in one episode. I've never really done that in my videos before. That's really quite something new. Yeah, I just really like new experiences in games. I was only really able to experience it as a kid before, so I just want to experience that awesome feeling once again, for the first time in a very long time, especially in a Pokemon game, in Pokemon Sun and Moon. So you know, I haven't experienced that feeling in really years, literally years. Some people don't care for that feeling, they just want to know stuff about a game, like be informed, tell other people about it, spoil them too. Yeah, they don't really care about it, they just want to know the stuff and have it be convenient. Be in depth on the stuff. You know, all the codings and stuff. All that. They just want to be informed. They don't really care about an awesome new experience. They just want to be informed. Okay, but now we're gonna enter the last password here. Now we can enter the Team Rocket Warehouse. Rocket Warehouse. And yeah, this is quite a new thing. Haven't really been here before. Go here? No, that was progressing. Get an upgrade. That's how you evolve Porygon in the Porygon 2. And I don't think we healed up. We didn't heal up, did we? No, we didn't heal up. Crud. We have to deal with this Houndour here. Hopefully you guys were actually paying attention to the game when I was rambling there. That wasn't like a mini podcast. That was me playing through the game, but just rambling at the same time. So hopefully you guys were paying attention to what I was doing. I kind of went off and mentioned what I was doing. I was kind of just exploring the game, and then when I got to a main point, I was like, oh, here we are. But yeah. Now that rambling's done, you can actually focus on the game, and hopefully, like I said, hopefully you guys were actually focusing on the game and not just my rambling. But if not, you guys are like, oh wow, he's suddenly in the Rocket Warehouse. But really, I've been paying attention this whole time, just been rambling at the same time. And I believe this is the way to go. Take a bell, this grunt, and go a different path. Dude, this guy's gonna chop. Yeah, I've been rambling this whole episode. I'm just kind of more into that rambly mood now. I'm not even into the game. I'm not even immersed in the game anymore. I'm just immersed into talking to you guys more than I am in the game. I'm just kind of just like playing this in the background now. Hopefully I'll get back in the swing of things soon. What do you think you're doing? Well, I think I'm defeating you. That's what I think. I don't know about you. And this is the way we go. No, but we were close. This way? I've already been this way though, haven't I? Ah, I see now. Clever. Really freaking clever. We can also go up here and get access to a TM, I believe. This is TM for Sludge Bomb? Yes, indeed, it's a TM for Sludge Bomb. And here we got the last in the way Team Rocket Grunt. I don't know or care if what I'm doing is right or wrong. I just put my faith in Giovanni and do as I'm told. Well, you know, Giovanni kind of disbanded Team Rocket. Of course, you guys don't know that because you're in the Savvy Islands, which is far away from Kanto, but, you know, if Giovanni isn't telling you to do anything anymore, then why are you still doing it? I always do stop after they realize that Team Rocket did disband Team Rocket. Oh, come on, one minimize. I can guarantee that pretty much all of you aren't used to me just rambling on videos, because normally I'm just talking about the game. But, you know, this time I was actually just rambling about something, and we got paralyzed somehow. Well, they used Star Spore. I'm not even remembering stuff, I'm just having to, like, actually remember it before I say it. And we're gonna die here. Rip Sanic, rip in pieces, buddy. I really should have switched back into Russian. Truvia still has Ice Beam. Yeah, it's Thunderbolt that we took away, because, you know, we already have Thor for Thunderbolts. So that doesn't really matter. And there are my dogs in the background. Great. I did take away Psychic, because, you know, none of my other team members have a Psychic-type attack, so... Just take away Thunderbolt, because Thor already has it. Take away that for a Waterfall, of course. Waterfall was required to advance this story. We actually can use it if we're just finishing off an opponent. And... they're letting us go back now. Better steal your stuff for one harsh challenge. Yeah, because that last grunt, he's the strongest out of all of them. And we can just fly back to the Pokemon Center. Not really that much of a trouble to go back. I'm just gonna go back and heal up, and I'll be right back at the laboratory. Warehouse, I mean. Look at all these Pokemon, though. It's a lot of Pokemon here. We got a lot of them. It's still not close to all of them, though. I mean, we haven't got any Hoenn Pokemon. But yeah, I'll meet you guys back at the warehouse. We're back in the warehouse, about to take on this last grunt here. It's quite enough of you playing the hero, kid. Spreading lies about how Team Rocket has disbanded? It's the truth! You can ask Giovanni, well, if you could find him. He kind of left. Such an obvious attempt to cause confusion in our ranks. Fortunately, we're not so ignorant to fall for the lies of a child. Unfortunately for you, it's not a lie. So this is actually an admin, not a grunt. And here we got Roshan take on his Golbat, I guess. And it's still way lower level than us, but it is decent levels. So mid-50s, that's pretty decent. That's the highest level that the host game has gotten. And 54 as well. We're still gonna sweep though, well, not gonna sweep, I guess. And are we gonna die again? Okay, we didn't. Good. Oh! I used Double Edge, so now Roshan's gonna die. Oh, he survived, never mind. There we go, now he's got a Houndoo. Imagine if they remade Kanto again, and they even included the Savvy Islands once again, and this guy had like a Mega Houndoo. Like he was the next Team Rocket boss or something, and he just had a Mega Houndoo here. That would be pretty epic. I wish they would remake Kanto again, but, you know, not going to. And there we go, Roshan's level 63. And it wasn't really a challenge. We were too strong. That's Giovanni's patch. So it's true? Team Rocket really has disbanded? Yes, it is true. You could only believe me if I showed you his badge. Huh. We will abandon this warehouse. I don't think this is over. I won't let this be the end. I will find Giovanni, and I will resurrect Team Rocket. I will. Until then, farewell. And that kind of hints at why Team Rocket suddenly decided to regroup in Johto. And now we're gonna go to this guy here. We're gonna go to this guy here, and once we beat him, we'll get the Sapphire back. Yeah, once we defeat this guy, we're gonna be pretty much done with the Sevii Island side quest. We just gotta give the Sapphire back to Celio. I remember his name because it's very similar to a Pokemon's name. Yeah, we're just gonna defeat this guy, get the Sapphire back from him, give that Sapphire to Celio, and that'll be pretty much the end of the side quest. This guy's got a Porygon here. That's his last Pokemon there. This guy wouldn't really have a Mega if they gave him a Mega in a remake, if that ever happens. Which, this is a remake, so that'll be a remake of a remake, pretty much. If I can't sell it, it's worthless. Go ahead, take it. And we got the Sapphire back from him.
And the Scully guy just gave the Shinkiller a drink.
Oh. The Scully guy's in here now. My brother Scully. Oh well, pretty close to ending the episode anyway. But yeah, we just gotta... We don't really need to fly back. We can just walk back in Sonic Fast mode. Ba-ba-ba-ba. And now we're gonna go back to one island. Go back to one island. And here we are back in one island. This place actually doesn't use Johto music. Like the other islands do. And here we are back to Celio. We're gonna give him the Sapphire and our Repelled as well. And there we go. Gave him this Sapphire. So, this is the gem that forms a pair with a Ruby. Should have been obvious, haven't you played the original Gen 3 games? The Shikyor, you've gone through a lot to get this, didn't you? Oh, yes I did. I found it in the dotted hole, but then the scientist stole it and had to go through Team Rocket's warehouse and all that crud. You don't have to tell me. I know it wasn't easy. Thank you so much. He knows it wasn't easy because it took a while. It took a whole episode. Now it's my turn to work for you. Please give me a little time. It actually took a bit more than an episode. Like, an episode and a half, pretty much. Okay, this is good. He's gotta prepare his machine. I did it! I linked up with Lynette. The Shikyor. The Shikyor, I did it! I managed to link up with the trainers in the Hoenn region. Finally, the network machine is fully operational. The Shikyor, I owe it all to you! Thanks to you, my dream came true. I'm not crying. That's enough of me. The Shikyor, you're going to keep looking for exotic Pokemon, right? I wish you the best of luck. And basically what this machine does is, in these games, it allows you to trade with Pokemon Ruby and Sapphire players. So yeah, now the Sevii Island side quest is finally done. We did everything in the entire side quest, and this episode was likely a lot longer than the last one, but I had to cut that one short because I was interrupted. But yeah, now this episode is over, and we completed the post-game quest. So yeah, now next time, we have some legendaries to catch. I hope you guys are excited for that episode, because that episode is going to be legendary. I'll see you guys then, and happy hunting!